Folks, we're waiting on this, the expected launch of the Artemis I mission less than a month away.
NASA's anticipated launch date, August 29th, but the process will get started much sooner. News 19's Emily Mosner joins us live in studio now. So, Emily, of course, launch day will bring a lot of excitement, but what will happen between now and then?
Well, the short answer to that question is a lot will happen. Today, NASA officials gave an update on the Artemis I mission and what it'll bring. Now, much like the actual countdown during the launch, there's also a countdown to that launch date.
Just 26 days.
August 29th will bring a long-awaited launch for NASA. The SLS rocket will launch the Orion spacecraft on an unmanned mission as America prepares to return to the moon.
It will be on a mission of over a million miles to the moon and back, and all kinds of orbits around the moon testing this spacecraft.
The Artemis I mission will last for 42 days. The purpose is to gather information for future missions, setting the stage for America to return to the moon and have the first woman and first person of color walk on the lunar surface.
To all of us that gaze up at the moon, dreaming of the day humankind returns to the lunar surface, folks, we're here.
NASA Administrator Bill Nelson says Artemis I will inspire, just like the Apollo missions inspired past generations.
This is now the Artemis generation.
The rollout for the launch is slated for August 18th. That is the process of getting the rocket from where it is now in the vehicle assembly building to the launch pad. From now until then, final checks and tests are being run.
All of the work is on schedule to support our planned rollout date.
After the rollout, the rocket will await the perfect conditions before launching from the Kennedy Space Center. Once the Orion finishes its orbit of the moon, it will come back to Earth. When the capsule is retrieved, that's when more work begins.
This test flight will be one that provides us a tremendous amount of data, and I expect we're going to learn a lot.
Space Launch System Program Manager John Honeycutt says the data will be provided by thousands of sensors that are on the rocket. Of course, hundreds of man hours went on right here in Huntsville at the Marshall Space Flight Center to get us where we are now. Once the data from the Artemis I mission is analyzed, NASA can start working on the Artemis II mission, the first crewed mission of the program. Another Artemis I update is scheduled for later this week after a final launch team training event gets started tomorrow. Of course, we will keep you updated on everything related to the Artemis launch.